Okay, the Xbox is downloading some games in the background and there's enough time to do a couple of videos and we're starting with comparison between the new gamepad from the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Elite controller and also my old Xbox 360 wireless controller and just to have it on board the good old PlayStation 4 controller. Welcome back to my channel. Okay, so the first time when I had the new Xbox Series controller in my hand, I really thought there's something different. And it is indeed. And not just the material quality or the structure here is different. No, also the white and the scale or whatever you call this. So I just have the Xbox Elite controller, so I'm not sure if this is actually complete different to the normal Xbox One controller. I have no idea, to be honest. But what I found, so I really like this controller. So I'm using this. I prefer this controller over this one. Okay, sorry to say, but this is just better for my hands. Okay, so what I found when I had this or unpacked this one. There's a big difference in weight. So, and when we compare the weight from all the different controllers, so there's no battery or nothing in, then for the new Xbox Series X controller, we have around 240 gram for this one. For the Xbox Elite controller, also no batteries in, we're talking about 290 grams. So this is already 50 gram more than this one. That's why it feels really, really, yeah, it feels heavy, this one. 240, 290, this is 50 gram more, and this is really, you can feel it. Anyway, so we still have this, I'm missing this actually, but doesn't matter. We have the old Xbox 360 with 210 gram, let's say 220, okay? And of course the PlayStation 4 controller, which comes to 217, 218 grams, okay? So let's keep this here for now. We talk about this on Thursday, okay, when I'm doing the unboxing for the PlayStation 5. Let's focus on this one. And I have to say, I'm very, very surprised and very impressed with the new or the standard controller, which is supplied by Microsoft with the console. So because I gained a little bit, of course, Gears Tactic and the Falconeer already, and this is really great controller. What I haven't tried so far is to connect this one on my Xbox. I'm very sure you can actually connect this one to this one, or is this possible? I really don't know. Really don't know. There's a lot to test, to be honest, but so far I'm used to this controller. Very much, because I'm using this very often when I'm doing PC games. And what I really like is the triggers, because they are really, you can feel the quality. Okay, so let's say it like this. When you come from the Xbox 360 controller, which is a very cheap one but still a very good controller, you don't want to touch this anymore when you had this in your hand for just one minute, you know. And not to talking about the adjustable stuff and whatever, but this is a different story. The buttons or the triggers and all the buttons on the Elite controller are really just superb. There's really nothing what I can complain. Probably maybe just the weight, and yeah, the rest is fine. And maybe it's a little bit noisy, but anyway. So when I played with this one, just for half an hour, so Gears Tactics a little bit, I was really, really impressed with this one. Because first of all, they changed the measurements a little bit. So the Xbox, let me just try this. Let me just try to, maybe you can see this. So it's really hard to, it should work like this. So can you see? This is different. Also the shape is different. So it's a little bit wider on the bottom. I hope you can see this, the new one. But from the, let's say, height, I would say it hides. So if I'm doing this and this, I'm matching this up and just trying to do this, right? It's very hard, to be honest. It's very hard. Just give me a second. Oh, God. Oh! See? The new Xbox controller is slightly not that tall, or maybe it's just a maybe, but it looks like I tried to measure it, to be honest. I just have these tools here and it's very hard to actually measure it, and this is around 90, I would say. Now it looks to me it is a little bit less in the height here, and of course 50 grams less, which makes this controller at the moment, just from the feeling here, much better, not much better, but better than this one. Okay, so yeah, I have to say it's really, at the moment I like to use this more or over this one, because it's just because of the height, because of the grip. And now we're talking about the buttons here and the trigger. I was really impressed about this. This is such a great quality, and if I compare this with the Elite controller, there's no difference. I don't think there's any difference. Okay, of course you don't have all the settings here and adjustments, but hey, this is supplied by the console. I paid for this, I think $200 or whatever, so just keep this in mind. Okay, this is the standard controller now. You know, you can buy this for, I don't know how much money, $50 to $100, I don't know, to be honest. And this, the trigger buttons, really great. The only thing, this is okay, this is a little bit noisy, the D-pad. And of course, what you can see, or what you can hear here, I think the steering, what is the steering pads, whatever you call this, they are not as good as on the Elite. The Elite is still better in this category. Anyway, I think this controller, what is now supplied as a standard controller for the Xbox Series X and Xbox Series S, probably, I'm very sure it's the same, really impressive. Really impressive. Okay, more noisy here than this one, but actually I'm happy because I paid so much money for this one, and I would be very sad if this one has a better quality than this one. But that's how it is. This is really, really good, really great in comparison with really. We started with this one, and this is still in a very good shape here because I'm, yeah, taking care about my stuff. But you can, this is such a, and this was really, this is, was one of the best controller back then, and now today they improved it up that huge. It's really, really impressive, and again I really, really like it. So, and what I'm trying to do now, I'm trying to hook up this on my Xbox. Let's see if it's working. So, and of course it's working, and of course you don't need this one because this is just for the PC. It's connected, and again my controller needs an update, which is it's just great. But anyway, happy that this one is working the same like this. I'm not sure which one I'm using. So even the grip, you know, just to give you an idea, so this is rubber. This is really, it's not just plastic. This is just plastic here, but this is the same structure, and it really feels good. And the question is, of course, after a couple of gaming sessions or whatsoever, a couple of hours, the actually question is, which one, yeah, is more sweaty after a couple of hours? Is it this one with the rubber or this one with the plastic structure? I don't know. We will see, because it's getting so hot. And okay, let's finish this and then let's try this. Okay, so update finished, and my Assassin's Creed Valhalla is almost, yeah, it's playable for sure. And I don't know what's going on with my internet today. It's so slow, or maybe it's just the Microsoft servers. Anyway, I have a couple of games that I like to test and play later on with this controller. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and don't miss any new videos, because a lot of videos are coming with the Xbox, and this was just the beginning. And I think the next video what I'm doing is about the picture settings from the LG CX and the Xbox. And yeah, see you next time. Bye.